Good evening. Welcome to Harum Scarum, the show where we learn firsthand the horrifying, hair-damaging experiences of everyday people. Tonight, our guests are Gwen Nyquist, perm victim. Val Dooley, unsuspecting target of wig scam. And Dion Dion. Consultant representative from the Chateau de Toupee Hair Institute. Gwen, tell us about your experience.
Well, it was on the eve of my wedding day, and I cut out a picture of Melissa Manchester, and I brought it to Vince at Merle's House of Beauty. And I said, I want to look exactly like her. So Vince says, you should have a perm, your hair's too thin. So I believed him, it was Vince. So Vince puts the rods in, and then he turns to me and he says, coffee? I says, sure, double, double.
What's double, double?
Double cream and double sugar. So Vince goes off, and I'm halfway through the Enquirer when I realize that 4 hours have gone by and Vince isn't back. Well, I did the puzzle, and so then a policeman comes in and tells me Vince was mugged and he won't be able to take the rods out.
So then what happened?
Well, I didn't get married because of this.
Oh, my God. Was Vince prosecuted?
Well, you know, you really can't blame Vince. Oftentimes, in many perm cases, you cannot remove the rods on time due to uncontrollable circumstances and sometimes muggings. But on the other hand, I will admit that there are hairdressers in the business that are what is known as scissor happy. In the world of hair, anything can happen.
Well, do you have any advice for Gwen here as to how she can live a normal life with this affliction?
Oh, certainly. I suggest you visit the Chateau du Toupee. We will fit you with what we call a transitional wig, and of course, we offer group sessions for other perm victims such as yourself.
Oh, well, that sounds very helpful, thank you.
What about me?
Oh, yes, I was coming to you. Val Dooley, ladies and gentlemen, victim of a wig scam. Val, what happened?
Well, it wasn't my wedding day or anything like that, but I was at the mall, and I used to have hair down in my buttocks. And it was just like Crystal Gale.
Oh, she's got a head of hair.
Anyway, I was going up the escalator, and suddenly I feel something brushing against me, and I just figured it was some guy from voter registration.
Sure.
And I get to the top, and I feel lightheaded, and I look in the mirror, and somebody's just cut off my hair. It's just gone. It's just all gone. And a friend told me later that it happens a lot to Chinese girls. It's like a scam or something. And what they do is they cut off your ponytail and they make it into a wig.
Well, are you at all Chinese?
No, I don't think so. But I do believe that there is a demand for my hair color.
Well, what color was your hair?
Well, it was very much like his.
Well, this is just an outrageous story. Mr. Dion, you are in the wig business. Perhaps you've heard of this.
No, I've never heard of it. It is a shock to me.
Well, that's just not true because the police told me that it happens all the time. I mean, who's to say that the people that are selling you your hair for your wigs aren't selling you hot hair? I mean, who's to say that that isn't my hair sitting on top of your head?
Well, that's all the time we have for today, folks. Join us next week on Harum Scarum when our guests are Vida Cosgrove, who lost her hair in a hunting accident, and Sonia Riddle, who shaved her head for attention. Thank you and good night.